Good morning. Headlines for today's news bulletin are: researchers design DNA sensor for quick pathogen detection. IIT researchers develop IoT-enabled ultrasound scans. UK scientists use plants to produce a new polio vaccine. US scientists identify a way to make hair grow. Now moving on to the main news. Researchers design DNA sensor for quick pathogen detection. Scientists from CSIR Institute of Genomics and Integrative Biology and National Center for Disease Control, Delhi, have developed an ultra-sensitive DNA sensor that can detect Streptococcus pyogenes, a bacterium which causes a wide range of diseases, in about 30 minutes. The DNA chip-based sensor consists of a carbon electrode embedded with gold nanoparticles. By means of a bioinformatics study, the researchers were able to design probes which are specific for this bacterium, Streptococcus pyogenes. Researchers are now working on the construction of different biosensors for different pathogens. Early and quick diagnosis can help in preventing the diseases and seek medical treatment at the early stage of infection. IIT researchers develop IoT-enabled ultrasound scans. A team of researchers from IIT Hyderabad has been working to use the Internet of Things, or IoT, to accurately diagnose kidney and liver disorders with the help of ultrasound scanning devices. What started off as a project to develop a system that will validate the data and do a preliminary scanning of the organ, whether the organ is normal or not, has now developed into technology that can identify kidney stones and cysts and also create a fatty liver classification. The algorithm that the researchers have developed can be integrated into any platform and is flexible from the point of view of the hardware being used. They have also included a cloud-based authentication figure or feature that allows identification of the operator by means of iris and fingerprint scans. The researchers believe that there is a need to collaborate with hospitals and with the government and integrate this algorithm with devices. This will make it possible to extend medical support into the rural areas. UK scientists use plants to produce a new polio vaccine. Plants have been used to produce a new vaccine against poliovirus in what is hoped to be a major step towards global eradication of the disease. A cross-cutting team of scientists at the John Innes Centre, Norwich, UK, has produced the novel vaccine with a method that uses virus-like particles, that is the known pathogenic mimics of poliovirus, which are grown in plants. The virus-like particles have been biologically engineered, so they do not contain the nucleic acid that allows viruses to replicate. This means that they mimic the behavior of the virus, stimulating the immune system to respond without causing an infection of poliomyelitis. The breakthrough was made by a consortium funded by the World Health Organization, which is seeking to eradicate a disease that has been known since antiquity. The WHO is seeking alternative vaccines that avoid use of the live virus as part of an international drive to completely eradicate the virus worldwide. US scientists identify a way to make hair grow. Researchers at the University of California have discovered a new way to activate the stem cells in the hair follicle to make hair grow. The research may lead to new drugs that could promote hair growth for people with baldness or alopecia, which is hair loss associated with such factors as hormonal imbalance, stress, aging, or chemotherapy treatment. As hair follicle stem cells consume the nutrient glucose from the bloodstream, they process the glucose to eventually produce a metabolite called pyruvate. The cells can then either send pyruvate to their mitochondria, a part of the cell that creates energy, or can convert pyruvate into another metabolite called lactate. The team identified two drugs that, when applied to the skin of mice, influenced hair follicle stem cells in distinct ways to promote lactate production. The experimental drugs have been used in preclinical tests only and have not yet been tested in humans or yet approved by the Food and Drug Administration for safe and effective use in humans. Thank you.